Santa Sue. Devin Streeton here. Welcome back to KSSH News at Noon.
And I'm Haley. Devin, what's with that stupid football?
I've been waiting for this since August. The Super Bowl! Football! Two of the best teams clash on the gridiron. That's downright unpatriotic.
Why, it's yawning?
Hey Santa Sue, Ryan Rogers here to talk to you about the most important part of game day. Not the game, the snacks. Today, we're going to be making homemade hot wings.
Step one, get chicken.
Step two, put the chicken on the grill.
Next, select your hot sauce.
Next, pour the hot sauce in the bowl. Next, add some seasoning into the sauce. I don't even know what this is. Mix the seasoning. You should probably use a spoon, but... Next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your chicken and you're gonna put it in the sauce. Well, there you have it, Santa Sue. This is about as close as I'm going to get you to hot wings. So, back to you in the studio.
Everyone looked amazing at winter formal.
Good thing our fashion reporters got all the hot threads on camera.
Hey now, hey now. Hey now, now.
Hi guys, I'm Isabella Martinez.
And I'm Drew Shapiro, and we're here at the 2014 Fantasy Winter Formal.
And we want to know what you're wearing.
I got my suit at the 3-day suit burger.
And I got my dress from Couture. Couture.
Tonight I'm wearing my little sister's 8th grade graduation dress and a top from American Apparel.
This outfit was all purchased at Windsor in the Oaks Mall. All from the headband to the shoes and necklace too. The dress is definitely a favorite for me.
Oh, look who it is. It's our producer and our scriptwriter. My fabulous outfit. Where'd you guys get it from?
Windsor. The web exclusive 8th grade.
All right, so we're decked from head to toe in Kanye West APC collection. Abu Dhabi,
you know what it is.
Hi, I'm Taylor Welch, and I got my dress from Windsor.
This from the music freshman year. It's our tux. And this is from online.
Never seen Miss Mayo wear the same outfit.
You know, now that you mention it, neither have I.
Hey guys, it's me, Isabella Martinez. Here on campus, we have an incredible fashionista, Miss Mayo. Let's go check out some of her great looks.
I'm as principal, I really do see myself as a role model. Here we go now. I like clothes that I think are cute.
yo, yo, look at me, walking down the runway like a VIP.
I love vintage patterns. I think they're creative. I think they're fun.
Believe me, hey, B, I'm doing my thing, and when I say what, me.
Obviously, I try to communicate, you know, professionalism, the attention to respecting all students in the community.
Super exciting, super fun evening.
Financial aid night! Here's more.
I know I'm gonna get a scholarship. What about you?
Hi, Kimberly Paul's here reporting at financial aid night in the MUR.
I came here because I needed some financial aid.
I need money for college. Because my mom made me come.
I've always wondered how I'm gonna pay for college.
I just don't wanna spend that much money on college.
My mom and my sister made me.
I came tonight to find out about all the scholarships, grants, and things that are being offered.
I'm a single parent and I have a junior here at Santa Susana and concerned how I'm going to pay for college.
I'm here to help my daughter plan for her college future.
Do you know what college you're going to?
Moorpark.
No, I don't know what college I'm going to go to.
I'm going to Moorpark College.
Moorpark College.
Moorpark?
We have Amy from Kowloon. She's here to present on anything that you need to know about financial aid.
Financial aid is not necessarily for paying your entire way to school. It's not always free money either. So basically, financial aid is designed to bridge that gap between what you can afford and what the school actually costs. And that's why the FAFSA was created, to understand or to try to understand what you can afford.
Devin, what are you doing?
I'm writing a poem for my Valentine.
I'm gonna try this instead.
Hi.
She's beautiful.
Oh my god, do you like her?
No.
Do you like her?
No.
So if you don't like her, do you like her?
Yes! I like her. But I don't know how to tell her.
Do you guys talk?
Well, yeah, like, I talked to her plenty of times. Like,
oh, okay.
There was this one time when... And then the next time that it happened, it went really well. It went like this. And like one time, she even tried to hold my hand.
Look, Grant, she's right over there. I need you to get the courage, okay? I'm getting sick of that.
I did it with the help of Abbey Road Acapella Choir, and they'll help you too for a small fortune. Get your choirgram today.
A rose by any other name
would smell like a small rodent.
Children's theater put on a ton of shows that most of us don't even know about.
I like secrets. Every year, Children's Theater travels to elementary schools around Simi Valley to perform. Let's see what these traveling troubadours are up to.
My show is called Wishing You Were Here, and it's about a little girl who's struggling with being lonely until she finds her fairy godmother.
Hi, I'm Haley Hayes.
And I'm Haley Hayes.
So what's your show about?
My show is Captain Bree, and it's about a band of female pirates that take over a British military ship.
My show is called Twinderella. It's about Cinderella and her long-lost brother, Bob.
What is the best part about performing for children?
The best part about performing for children is definitely, like, they actually believe that you are the character. So I've had kids, like, come up to me and, like, give me flowers as presents, or, like, they invite me to their birthday parties, and they truly believe that you are the character, and it makes them so happy, and that's the best part.
My favorite part of performing for children would probably be when they don't understand a joke and they laugh, and it's just like the most awkward thing, but it's so funny.
Another happy ever after, like, not to be confused with
mention Obama's new dream tax.
Well, I can't wait. This is going to be the most awesome fairy godmother. It'll make everyone so happy.
Children's Theater is unique because we get to travel to different elementary schools, and we get to perform for them.
Wishing you were here!
And that's the way it is.
Wait, there's another story.
What does a burrito and hairspray have in common? Nothing. But when you put them together, you get a really wet burrito.
It's time for the U.S. Army Field Band.
So, after the credits, head on down to the amphitheater.
And that's the way it is.
January 29th, 2015.
Have a spiffy day, Santa Sue! Yeah.
Dude, what's wrong?